What's up, YouTube?
I know.
Everyone thought I died on here, I think. And I really don't vlog that much. Anyways, a lot has been happening in my life. Where do I start? You know what? I'm just gonna say, we built a Sema car. I'm going to an anime convention. Mason's been doing shots. Lucas is pretty drunk.
We've all been doing shots.
I don't drink, so I'm playing daddy tonight. So let's go, boys.
Oh, daddy.
Let's go.
Thanks for coming back to the channel. I really appreciate the support. New hoodies are up on the site. But for now, enjoy this vlog, and I'm excited to get you guys back into the whole swing of things. And just like that, we're in Vegas. So I'm gonna go over to the Meguiar's booth in a little bit, and we're gonna go check out their exhibition car. Kyle and Ross did an amazing job finishing this thing up last minute and dedicating pretty much all their free time and their sanity to this build, and it really shows. I've been walking around probably Central Hall and South Hall most of the morning, and it's only about 11 o'clock right now, but it's probably the best car. Dude, shout outs to you guys, you killed it. Let's go check this out so you guys can see it. I've already shot a bunch of photos and we just made it live on the internet. So we're gonna go there. I'm gonna weave through all this traffic. If you guys have never been to Sema before, saying that it's big is an understatement. It's like the size of our local convention hall times six, and it's just absolutely insane. It's crazy how much drifting in the last like 10 years has really picked up dominance in this market. There's actually a lot more booths that care about it, you can tell. There's a lot of the FD cars are here. Ryan Literal's parked kind of close to us. Matt Powers is right next to that. We'll go check those out in a little bit, but I'm gonna try and give you guys as much as you can, but so many people vlog this that I don't feel the need to really vlog it any more than others do. So I'm here to take photos for Kyle and Ross. I'm gonna do as much as I can, and then we're almost to Meguiar's. It's a massive booth. So I figured now should be a good time to start vlogging again since I didn't all day. Sorry. So Kyle, why don't you tell the people on the internet what happened today?
So we got top 10 Battle of the Builders Young Guns. I don't really know what that means.
He's acting like it's not a big deal. It's a really f***ing big deal because he wasn't even like an official entry in this thing. So basically tomorrow we're going to find out if he's top 3 essentially around noon. So we'll have an update for that. We currently almost got into the wrong Uber or an Uber with someone and like sat on his lap, so we didn't decide to. Ross, are you stoked on how the day's gone so far?
Yeah. It's like, I can't even absorb everything that's happened.
I was gonna say that. Like I was vlogging at probably 1 o'clock and I was like, it's kind of impossible to sit here and say how I feel about like everything that's happened.
Like you're gonna need time to like literally process everything that's happened. Like our car 4 months ago was like a raw metal shell, and now it's Central Hall at Sema, and probably 50,000 people have seen that. It's just
like, we know for sure that it's a hyped up car, but the fact that when you sit there for 10 minutes and like 45 people have taken photos of it really puts it in perspective of how excited the internet and people are about the car. So we're gonna go back to the hotel, and we're never gonna wear backpacks again to Sema because it was the dumbest decision we've ever made. Kyle's feeling great.
We need to get a tool belt for water bottles though.
Yes, we gotta figure something out. We're gonna come tomorrow and want our backpacks for some reason, but I don't know if sponsors will see this, so shout out if you see it. We can't thank you enough. Seriously, like this experience has been unreal, and I don't think any of us really expected it to be what it's been so far. So we'll have an update for you. We might vlog tonight. We might go to Steve Aoki tonight. We're starving, but that's what the priority is right now. So see you later, internet.
Ross is so here, fucking burger that he's missing all this.
Thank you.
they have that big radium system. Probably trying to f***ing pull so much. So it's like, oh no.
Yeah.
Right hand down a little bit.
Yeah, start turning.
Down turn.
Keep it rolling, guys. Yep, keep it rolling.
Alright, so here's me gonna check the fictional watch that I have on my wrist, and it is 9:30-ish. Last night we got done at the strip at about 5-ish, and we're going to meet up with Kyle, who didn't get done at the strip at about 5-ish, and he's in the top three of the Sema Young Guns, and the final judging for that starts in about 10 minutes, and me and Ross are gonna be fashionably late, and maybe even more fashionably late, because we want some f***ing coffee. So we're gonna walk to the monorail now and try and find a Starbucks or something and pay $8 for a coffee, since that's what it costs here. I left my camera stuff at Gio's house because we assumed I was gonna be done at like 1 o'clock, but instead Ross messaged me at like 2 a.m. because I was at Little John's DJ set at the MGM club. And Ross texts me, he's like, you should probably get here because I'm at the Luxor. And I meet up with Ross and he's like two or three, four, five Red Bull vodkas deep. So we're all feeling a little bit dead, but morales are high. It's been crazy, waking up to crazy text messages. I woke up to a dead phone, so I don't know, that's how this is going. And I'm gonna try and meet up with Gio in a little bit. I haven't even put him in this vlog yet, so I'm sorry, Gio. I haven't had my camera most of the day. And I haven't even vlogged that much for you guys, but we'll run through it and I'll make this work somehow. But anything you want to say?
I need coffee.
That's all we need is coffee. So, they're judging up there for the Battle of the Builders, or Young Guns, whatever. They basically get a... like a 10-minute spiel about their car, you know, like how everything went down, what their favorite things are about it, basically to sell all the other builders on kind of the whole vibe of the car, what it's all about, what's their favorite pieces and all that. And then they actually judge each other about it. So that's what's really cool about the final level, is like it's basically a fan favorite towards the end. So luckily Kyle's a nice dude and has been making friends all this time. So we ran over to McGuire's and we grabbed some detail spray, we got some microfibers, and now Ross and me are gonna go through the whole car and just make it kind of look a little bit better for when he has to show it, because sadly I had to sit outside overnight waiting to get judged today. So we're gonna do that. Apparently this detail spray is good for the Lexan windows too, so shout out to you guys because you know us well. So yeah, we're gonna check in with Kyle hopefully in a little bit. I don't know, there's 12 contestants of the finalists and there's 10 minutes per kind of spiel. So we'll see how it goes. We'll see what's up to him in a little bit and we'll update you. So besides being baked alive in the sun right now, the car's wiped down for the most part. We just threw in the air back on so we can air up to get on this pretty massive ramp to get up here. So we're gonna do the final wipe downs. We're gonna move it to get lined up inside like kind of this thing to get judged. Hopefully that these panels cool down and stuff, we can do the last bit of detailing. So, and as an update, we have not gotten coffee yet. So here's Kyle back from his very long day. Yeah. What time did you go to bed last night?
Like 3.
We stayed up till 5. I don't know if you know this.
I know, because I was awoken when you came in.
Yes, that's why I didn't get in the bed, because I was like he's gonna be mad, but I tried to stay quiet. All right, so how's today been?
Busy.
Busy? So, you woke up at like 7 or 8, probably?
Yeah, 7:30-ish.
7:30. Then he came down here, and like I was talking about, they're doing all the judging and stuff, and that's been your entire commitment today.
Yeah, all day, so.
Did the hot girl that was coordinating flirt with you again?
No, I haven't seen her.
Oh, we're gonna try and find her. They've told us to move the car. We're gonna move the car, and they're like, do you have spotters? And we're like, yeah, I guess.
Sure.
Yeah. You're looking at them right now.
I don't know. Stop it.
Damn right, Kyle.
People here.
Damn right, Kyle. Just don't kill it again. Oh, that was you.
Oh, yeah.
The goods have been acquired. We're happy now. Now we're just waiting. We're gonna have to take this car to Sema United, so that makes our plan for tonight for sure doing Sema United. Yeah. Which is okay, we have a bunch of friends gonna be there and stuff, and it'll be good to kinda, I think it's pretty relaxed in terms of like the atmosphere there, so it's
supposed to be.
We can probably like bullshit and stuff with some people too, cause we wanted to talk to Fortune, Nick Swan, we wanted to talk to, what's his name from Rays?
Rowie
from Rays. I talked to him yesterday about some wholesale stuff, but then it worked out in like beautiful unison because then they started chatting with him over drinks last night. So that's the cool part about Sema is the important talks never seem to happen during the show. It's always at the parties.
Over drinks.
Yeah, over drinks. Not coffee though.
These are recovery drinks.
And yours is
absolutely.
Oh, do you?
Now you do. Right. We just drive the regular modular.
About that clutch going up this hill, but I don't think it'll be too much of an issue. We'll see what happens with the ramps. Damn, Ross about to get ran over. He-Man out here. Oh, it sounds so good. Good stuff. Yes, sir. All right, Kyle. In front of me, they are doing the final voting. Ross is a madman and decided to risk his life for this car. But
it's cost me too much not to.
And as we say, it was all for the culture. So we'll have an update in a little bit. I'm gonna go meet up with Gio and them, grab my camera so I can actually get a little bit of coverage just proper this time. And yeah, Kyle's gonna do his spiel and we're gonna hear it. Ooh, look at him. So proud of him. Look at him go. Oh, it's gone. How's the interview?
Good.
Dude, you fucking nailed it. You hit all the points you needed to hit.
Yeah, boy! So we are heading back to the stage to hear the final top four, correct?
Yeah, one from each class. Top from each class.
Yep. And we just had Doug and RJ come over and gift us with something super, super, super cool. Yeah, we were losing our minds. There's a little bit of livery inspiration for me here. I don't know, it's just so sick. You have like, I love the little hand style pieces, like super, he was stoked to do like this whole graffiti look to it, and I guess I could have had him talk about it, but shout outs to you guys. This is too cool. Yeah, we'll be talking to you in the future about other cars, and the next car they're building, we're gonna get it drawn too.
Absolutely.
Thanks again. Now we're gonna go see if,
I would have helped you up.
I don't know if you, I don't know how this works. He's just gonna keep following where they tell him to go, basically.
All right, you guys can't really hear, but there's.
So they were about to announce the young gun category, but instead someone started two-stepping. So, strangely fitting.
Brad Swain is 1971 Corvette.
Kind of hope he does a burnout, but. Where Ross is, I don't know where Kaiza is, I don't know where Eric is, but We are at the Sema rollout, I guess you would say. And there's a lot of stuff I don't care about. But there is one thing that was cool. I'll show you guys.
I got that shot.
Yeah.
Have you been on this vlog today, Gio? We're gonna go watch this for a little bit because my attention is really... Dude, this is just... It's just unsafe. We're gonna watch this for a little bit longer, and then we're gonna go down to Sema Ignited because that's where we took the Young Guns car. Currently under the Link, or what is that, the High Roller?
The
Link Hotel, so that's where I'm gonna stay. I'm not going to the hotel till 5 a.m. Phil just hit us up, and he was like, yo, come out to the Link's back yacht and come shoot some cars. So, I'm probably intruding by taking out my camera, but... So you're getting your car shot,
yes,
correct?
Yes, I am.
Yep, it's gonna be perfect. And then, do you guys have a location chosen, or are we just lurking here?
I think this is it.
Yes. Okay. So they just throw the valet guys $20 and they'll be like, yeah.
Well, they came by earlier and they were just like, yeah, as long as you don't park over there, because those are the actual valet spots, and we're like, we're just taking some pictures and we'll be out.
This is promo. When you have this cool of cars, it's just promotion. Yeah. So, yeah. So I'm here. We're going to take some photos. Shouts to Phil. Just was playing Initial D for an hour straight for free. It was sick. Yeah, so I'll show you guys some of these cars. It'll be sick. I'll have full res stuff up on the page. Thank you. I love you.
Oh, Lord, bro.
You have a Divinis on there?
This is Vegas. Yeah, so a little bit of everything tonight. Pretty stoked.
Oh, and you're, oh yeah.
Yeah, I was like...
Hey guys, so it's probably 6 to 8 hours, no, probably a little bit longer than that. About 8 hours since I've shot. We are currently getting the E30 from transport. This wheel had a bent lip when we got it originally, so we're gonna throw some air in that tire. We have a shoot with Toyo today, and we're actually all in really good spirits because they got good sleep. I didn't, but I have cold brew with a double shot of espresso that Ross just put me on and is giving me a heart attack, so. Yeah, we're gonna fill up this thing with some air and do some. Where are we gonna go exactly from here? Meet up with Eric and Ty.
They're meeting us here. We're gonna get the car ready. The springs have settled pretty heavily, so we need to make some suspension adjustments. Then we're gonna drive it about 4 miles south to this massive dried up lake bed.
And when we're driving there, I'll try and show you from the highway what it looks like, but it's basically just, it looks like a desert. And it's funny, because we're from Nebraska, so usually where it's flat like that, there's corn, but here there's just nothing.
Might as well, all the other ones look okay.
You can see we're rubbing on the R888s a little bit. Shout out Toyo. So we're gonna raise it up, probably what? I don't know, 1/4 of an inch. Using a sketchy Harbor Freight jack. See, some things never change. You can have a Sema built car and still be, you know, working on.
Yeah, let me tell you something. You know how you don't work on your own car? You wear white.
Yeah, it's true. Oh, I can't do this right now. Look, and I have a mint green shirt on, so yeah, we're on the same wave. We thought this was gonna be a quick suspension change, but instead what we're about to do is Dremel the freshly built Sema car. And we need to cut to make some clearance because the fronts are rubbing, just a tad. Can you not press the button when it's so close to your face? Just a little off the top, please.
Whenever you're ready.
Do you think they'll let us take it in our carry-on? Yay! Ooh, we started going like some hot butter at the end there.
Yeah.
You gotta get like the right angle. Mm-hmm. Just chop.
Throw in here, and it's all pretty rad stuff. That V8 screams in here, so I don't know if you guys heard any of that, so there might be subtitles right here. Kyle, how's today been?
Busy, I'm tired.
I'm hungry.
Got home from a desert, or back from a desert, not even back, we're at a warehouse now.
It got dark at like 5:10, completely blacked out, and it feels like it's midnight, and it's not even 8 o'clock. So, we don't know how this night's gonna play out. It might be a super long night, we might be done by midnight, but we have a shoot with Larry Chen. Okay, yeah.
I just got rundown that like one of the locations we're going to is not till 1 a.m., so.
Sick, bruh! I need a f***ing In-N-Out burger. Maybe another coffee from Dutch Bros. I know you ain't gonna see this, but if you need to bring me Dutch Bros right now, do it. So yeah.
Like an hour nap or something.
An hour nap, you know, maybe just go home and reset and come back in a week, but can't obviously do that. So, Kyle, I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
It's been rad. So yeah, I'll do some B-roll footage. We'll shoot throughout the night. We'll let you know how it goes, and thanks for watching.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe. Yo, buy some merch, cause I'm broke. So the LTO boys brought back some In-N-Out. I'm probably gonna poop soon. And now we're at Home Depot to grab some thicker gauge wire because...
Thinner gauge.
Oh, he didn't want a thick gauge, I guess.
We got some secret on a glow to surprise the boys.
But yeah.
We have to sneak around and put it on nonchalantly. So
we'll see how we can do this. But we're going to look at this really nice. No, it's not really nice. But it's cool. It's because it's a slammed FCR X7. It's slammed. It's dope. It's like a little Shackleton style.
You don't have your board?
So now we're playing camera car, kind of, or follow car, / block car, to watch this happen, and film this video. It's 2 p.m. We just slept like 3 hours because we asked for a late checkout. Yeah, that's an understatement. Wow. So, yesterday, and I didn't vlog about it much, I just haven't had time. We didn't sleep the night before. If you can't tell by my face. We met up with Larry Chen for a sunrise shoot. And here's how that started. So, this is Ross pulled over.
Do we know where it is? It'll be by his place.
What's up, you criminal?
What did they say?
Why not?
We can't shoot here.
Because it's too loud.
And that was a super awesome experience. He took us to this beautiful spot up on like Desert Inn Road that a lot of people go shoot at. And it kind of overlooks all of Vegas.
Are you recording video?
Mm-hmm. It gives an amazing backdrop. And then we ended up filming a video for Autofocus, the YouTube channel.
Wow. This is going in the vlog. Are you saying well?
Wow.
Wow.
So yeah, and that was awesome. Then from there we ran over to... I can't even remember. I think we back to the hotel to rest for a tiny bit. Then after that, we actually ended up heading to LA because the car is going to be stored here. So we have a little bit of time here in this beautiful city that's got some shitholes to it. And yeah, I'm walking to get some boba slash check out this 7-Eleven for a photo that I wanted to get. And I really apologize for not vlogging all the shit that's been going on this week, but we've been really busy. I've been trying to get more photo and video evidence of it all and compile it into something in the future, but Sema has been an absolutely amazing experience. This whole week's been an amazing experience. I want to thank Kyle and Ross, obviously, for the opportunity to document this entire thing and have fun along the way. But then also, like, everyone we've met along the way. Button Built, Kaisel, Eric with Live to Offend, Tim, you've been awesome. Like, Jordan, everyone we've made friends with. This has been a surreal experience. So I'm gonna run back to the Airbnb. We're about to get picked up by Mitch, and I think we're gonna go get some coffee. And then yeah, this trip's kind of winding down, but I can't lie. Usually I'm ready to go, but at this time I can't even front. I'm kind of ready for a nap and to see my dog and get all these edits up. So we're gonna do that. If this is the last time I talk to you, that's where I'm gonna end this. But yeah, hope I throw in some photos in here for you guys to see this, and I hope you enjoyed the Sema coverage.